What's up, everyone? James Murphy here from mcoding.io, where I offer live online courses in Python. Today, we're going to be talking about how to find primes using the sieve of Eratosthenes. So before we can write the sieve of Eratosthenes, first we have to understand what the algorithm is. Here's the main idea. You start with a big array. Let's say we want all the numbers that are prime less than 100. Then we'd make an array of length 100 full of Booleans. The Booleans are going to tell us whether the number is prime or not. Initially, everything is set to true, and then we're going to go through and successively mark composite numbers false. So first, we start at 2. That's prime. Then we take all of the multiples of 2, bigger than 2, of course, and mark them as false because they're composite. Then look through our array, and the next thing that's still marked true has to be prime. That's 3. Do the same thing for 3. Mark all of the multiples of 3 that are bigger than 3 as false. Then look at the array again, and you'll see that 5 is the next smallest thing. So let me show you a little graphic from Wikipedia that shows the algorithm in action. Okay, so as you can see, right now it's going through marking out all the multiples of 2. Then it finds 3 as the next prime number. It marks out all of those, and then it finds 5, and then it marks out all the multiples of 5, and then it finds 7, then marks out all the multiples of 7, and so on and so forth. So the idea is, go to each number that's marked true and mark out all of its multiples as false. Then, as you go through, the things that are still marked true as you go in order up from 2, you'll find that all of those things that are still marked true are primes. Okay, so now we understand the general idea of how the algorithm works. Let's get into how to actually implement it in Python. So I've already written here just the definition of the function. We're going to be calling it primes less than. It takes an integer where I want all of the primes that are strictly less than that integer. And I wanted to return a list of integers, the primes. So first off, let's get rid of some trivial cases. If n is less than or equal to 2, then, well, there are no primes less than 2. So let's just return the empty list. Otherwise, let's make an array which tells us whether a number is prime. So we're going to have Booleans in the array that are all initially set to true, and I want the length of the array to be n, so 1 for each number in our range. Then, of course, I will initially set 0 and 1 to be false, so is prime of 0 is false. And is prime of 1 is also false, because 0 and 1 are not primes. Next, we go through and start marking out composite numbers. So we'll go for I in range of 2 to n. Now, actually, we don't need to go all the way up to n, because if you have a composite number, then it has at least 2 factors. And one of those 2 factors, at least one of them, needs to be less than the square root of n. So we don't need to check all the way up to n. We only need to check up to the square root of n. So let me actually change this. I'll go ahead and use the built-in I square root function. So from math, import I square root, to get the largest integer less than the square root of n. So this will allow us to not have to go all the way up to n, but only up to square root of n. So that's going to be much more efficient. So I'll go through all the numbers from 2 up to the integer square root of my number, and then I'll check to see if I have a prime. So if is prime of I, and if so, then I need to mark out all of the multiples of that number that are bigger than that number. So I'll say for x in range. Now, another optimization that I can do here is I can actually start at the square of I. And the reason for this is, again, if I had a factor that was less than I, then it should have already been marked out by the previous iteration of the loop. So in fact, all I need to do is start out with the multiples of I that are bigger than or equal to I squared. So we'll start at I squared and go to n is the biggest. And if I start at I squared, which is a multiple of I, and I jump by I each time, then that's going to give me all those multiples. So just to remember the order of the arguments here, the first one in range is the starting value. The second is the stopping value, not including that value. And then the third is the amount to jump by at each step. So I'll go through these and then mark everything in here as not prime. Then that's basically it. I just need to now return the ones that are still marked prime at the end of it. So I'll just say return I for I in range of n if is prime of I. And if I didn't make any typos, that should be it. So there you have it, 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, and so on. That looks good to me. So there you have it. That's how you can find all the primes less than a certain number using the sieve of Eratosthenes.